should really set aside a day to honor and showcase our seniors, right? Let them show off their creative and analytical abilities and their engineering skills and their ability to work as a team. In all of our ABAD departments, which is Electrical and Computer Engineering, BME, Chemical Engineering, and Mechanical Engineering, we all have capstone design projects. So all the seniors have to do a design project. And starting this year, we'll also get optical engineering projects coming. And this year, actually, we have several computer science projects as well. So now all departments are involved.
And what are you using a shower curtain for?
Well, our device is a bidet system. So we're going to be demonstrating its spraying. So we're going to make sure that we don't get anyone else's project. But
yeah, so this is our ERG bicycle. We basically modified an old tricycle to be powered like a stationary rowing machine. So here you put your feet here, and then you hold on to this handle, and then this all moves. You have a moving seat so that you can actually pull that, and then that'll actually turn your back wheels. It was about 2 weeks to design it, and then another 2 weeks to build it.
We're given a project by the St. Mary's University Acute Rehabilitation Center. Specifically, our customer was Will Souls, occupational therapist. And they came to us with a project that there are limited mobility individuals, specifically obese limited mobility individuals, who the main reason that they cannot go home is because they are unable to clean their perineal region. So that was our main objective, was to create a system which could clean a perineal region of limited mobility individuals. So what we ended up making was a bidet system that is very user-friendly, very easy to use.
So you can adjust the lever arm to adjust the angle of the spray. And you can also adjust the pressure to follow after to change the pressure of the spray.
So we're the CoreFlow design team, and we're partnering with the Doily Lab here in the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. And we're designing a coronary artery perfusion system to perfuse the coronary arteries for use with intravascular ultrasound imaging, also known as IVUS, which the lab uses to study the mechanics of atherosclerotic plaques. So this is our heart chamber right here. We have a porcine heart in it. It is a real heart, yes. It's from the butcher shop. So we have a balloon catheter inserted into the coronary arteries that's perfusing fluid through our pump. And the IVUS can be inserted through the catheter and is used to get an ultrasound of inside the arteries.
Steve and I made a game for computers and Xbox that involves using your hero and attacking like these enemy units. And this was like a really fun single semester project. We just did it because we wanted to have some experience making a game. It's kind of a programming experience slash also a artistic experience. So that was kind of cool.
This is a vacuum flash distillation column for the purification of glycerol from the biodiesel production process. This is a distillation column, and it takes up the biodiesel through this tube here, and it goes through a pump, and it gets heated up and pressurized and then injected into a vacuum chamber where it is separated from its components, and it's vaporized. The vapor goes through here to a condenser, which is filled with cold water, and then it is sent and collected into this chamber here, while the non-glycerol goes into this collection chamber.
So we built a wheelchair that goes from sitting to standing, and the main goal was to try and increase blood flow and make it easier for someone that might be a paraplegic to reach things in higher position or let them be more comfortable in their day-to-day life. And I guess the way we did that was by making these roller, the collar here, so it decreases moment on a linear actuator, which is bearing the entire load right now. So it's approved for up to 150 pounds, at least that's what we've tested it for. So and then there are rollers down at the base right here that allows the chair to rotate under her.
Mostly we use companies or medical school professors and so on. And lots of local small companies in Rochester area. Rochester is a very high-tech area.
We're a local medical products company that has developed a device for balance assessment and fall prevention, as well as other therapeutic activities. And we engaged the biomedical engineering group here to help us design a lifelike robot that helps us do rapid product development and testing before we take products out to marketplace.
The robot is fully adjustable both in terms of height and weight, with BMIs capable of ranging between 19 and 42. Masses are added here as shown, like these hanging from the arms, as well as steel shot, which is available. Legs are adjusted through pin adjustments, and there's also torso adjustment.
So we engaged the team that we're talking to here last fall. And over the course of the last 6 to 8 months, we've seen the product go from design to actual implementation, which has been very exciting.
We're working with a company called QED Technologies, and they make this machine over here called the MRF machine. And what it does is it polishes lenses, and it basically fixes the surface of a lens or any optic to very precise accuracy.
Very pleased. Okay, I think the students have done a great job. The hardware looks very professional, the software looks very good, and so far it's meeting just about all the requirements. So, very good.
We are trying to license the technology to Invacare. They were very nice and actually donated the commode that we used. All of our devices attach specifically to Invacare commodes. So we are trying to talk with them right now as far as potentially getting licensing funding from that.
We might keep on working on it and eventually release it on Xbox Live Arcade. That'd be pretty cool. And maybe we'd make some money on it in the future.
So in the long term, what I envision this to go is I would like in the future we start running competitions. And I like to bring in more and more industrial participants and visitors and our alumna, bring them into this, seeing their little brother and little sisters show off their stuff. I think that's the direction we're headed.
This is the University of Rochester.